Hey everybody, Johnny Be Good here once again. Nothing's happening, just thought I'd share this drive right here. Kind of show you what California traffic looks like, I guess. For those of you who have never been to California. See what Californians look like and how they drive. Local time here is 10:17 a.m. By the way, the shipper that we picked up this morning was called Rinaldo's Mexican Food. I have no idea what they shipped in there, but it's set for 34 degrees. Continuous. I got three missions to do today. First and foremost is the pilot truck stop, or Loves or Flying J, so we could scan our paperwork, find us a TA or a Petro, get us some go-go juice and get us a shower. Showers are really bad. And then last but not the least, we got to get to a Walmart today. Hey, ERV, that's a Canadian truck. That's a Canuck truck. Hey, I just made it rhyme. A Canuck truck. I wish he would move over though. That's a beautiful Volvo right there. I wonder if Andrew Harrison is in there. Nope, that ain't Andrew. One can hope, right? By the way, I'd like to say hello and greetings to Roy Isaac. Oh, I guess that ERV had the right plan. Stay on the left because there's that big old slow truck on the right. See, I've always known the Canadians are not only smart, but they're good looking. They're always almost above average. Look at Andrew. I'm talking about Andrew Harrison. I'm serious. They're good looking, they're smart, they're above average. Right, Andrew? You know, I don't understand the love and hate relationship between Canadians and Americans. But I suspect that it's, I don't think it's jealousy. I think more of sheer boredom. Right? It just gotta be boredom. Americans and Canadians are bored, so they talk trash to each other. Not all of them, but I don't know, I've met drivers on each side that can talk trash on, you know, equally on the other side. But I think it's mostly Americans that don't like Canadians. I don't know why that is. Now in the Philippines, most people in Manila, we call them Tagalogs, they think less of us in the Visayas. They think of us as hillbillies and not so well refined as they are. And they think we're mean and someone to be feared. I don't know why that is. And then on the other side of that coin is we think Tagalogs are, oh, what do we call it, snobs and, oh, I don't know what, they're, I don't know what you call them in English. Someone who is too sensitive, especially when they talk. When they talk, I don't know. The Boston thing just came out when they talk. We also think. I think most Visayans think that Tagalogs are a little arrogant than the Visayans, I guess. Isn't it amazing? That prejudice and racism holds no colors. You can be prejudiced and racist in your own kind. It's weird, ain't it? It'd be really great if somebody were put a cable car way on top of the mountain up there and make that top of the mountain up there build a big castle resort, no, ski resort up there. I tell you, I think it will click real good. I've always been fascinated with castles and dungeons, and you know, one of my favorite movie was Sean Connery and Julia Ormond, and oh, what's his name? There's that one other actor in there that's quite famous. I can't remember his name now. The movie they made, Camelot. Oh, I like that show. Richard Gere, Sean Connery, and Julia Ormond. If a guy had plenty of money, he could build a castle. Way on top of the mountains up there. And of course, if you want to go there as a tourist, you had to dress the part, right? You can't go up there with shorts or, you know. Well, of course, it'd be cold, but you gotta dress the part, that way it will look authentic. One of the things I've always dreamed about doing was, I don't know if I ever mentioned this on YouTube or not, but one of the things that I've always been daydreaming was if you could make a replica of the Jewish temple, the original temple that they had way, way back then in biblical times. I'd like to see what it looked like. And a lot of Christians would like to go visit Israel, but that ain't gonna happen, right? So build a replica temple where everybody can visit and enjoy and see. Most especially the temple that they are talking about in the second coming of Christ. But then there would be a big sign on the gate that said replica only. That way it will not be mistaken or to compete for the one in the future. exit. Carlos gave me a phone call yesterday. I was in South Gate and I told him I had to hang up because I was trying to figure out which way to go. I told him I would call back and boy, I never did. How about we give him a call? Sorry I didn't call you yesterday. By the way, you're on YouTube.
Oh. Hello, YouTube. Hello, YouTube. Hey, John. How are you, man?
Oh, man, I'm sorry I forgot to call you back last night. What happened was they sent me to the wrong address, and I was all frustrated. And I had to figure out how to get to the shipper and...
Yeah.
So what's up?
Well, it's not like you drive a little four-wheeler, how you say, you know?
Yeah, you know, when you're pressed for time and the traffic is jammed and when everything goes wrong, well. But I got through it. By God's grace, I got through it.
Well, that's good. That's good. Yeah. I could hear the frustration there in your voice a little bit, so I'm like, okay, no problem, man. Don't even worry about it.
So was there something you wanted to say or asked or needed or what?
I kind of just wanted to share two things with you. There have been a couple folks who I had sent over to the JBG Travels website, you know, to listen, do the interviews and stuff like that, and they really, really, really liked them. They didn't really have a clear understanding of where I was in my walk. And when we hit the whole topic, you know, to do with, you know, the Lord and religion and how I got there and everything, a lot of, personal stuff had been shared and they had no idea. And they were like, whoa, we had no clue that was what was going on or how you came to now, I guess, and they were pretty happy about that, and they have been now kind of trying to ask questions here and there. So if anything, even one person were to now have a thought about the Lord and religion, I think that's pretty cool, man.
Yeah, I mean, that's basically what my channel is. I have an agenda.
Mm-hmm. It's a purpose.
Yeah, it's kind of like, I share the videos, and that way I can also share what I you know, my daily walk with the Lord, so.
I agree. And, you know, even if half of, you know, half the mustard seed was planted, that's all it really has to take sometimes, you know. So I'm glad that maybe somehow, somewhere, someone will catch these videos and, you know, they can, you know, they can be brought and they can listen to them and, you know, that can harvest something great.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyway, so that was the first thing. And the second thing, it's a little personal, but let me just speak in as much of a general way that I can. Last Sunday, John, there was a little bit of a breakthrough in the marriage and the breakdown of the communication from the past. And on Sunday, there was a little glimpse of a breakthrough. I received a phone call from you know who, crying, saying sorry, and I can't believe it has gotten so bad and so far, and that was not me, and it's the enemy. I have to find myself. I have to make amends with myself, but I did want to call and say I'm sorry. And as you probably know, I was shocked, stunned, my jaw hit the ground, but it was no coincidence as it was after church. So I think that, you know, he is a miracle worker, and he gave me a promise. I know he's a promise keeper, so it's all a process, John. And since then, there's been very, very short talks, obviously. There's some anger there. There's some bitterness. There's some shame. There's some blame. There's a whole bunch of things. But if anything, the lines of communication have opened up some. And, you know, a promise is a promise. And I'm just holding on to that. And I don't know, man. I don't know.
Well, Carlos, remember, slow to anger, slow to speak, and quick to forgive.
Absolutely. Well, that was first, John. That was absolutely one thing that I had to do first, and that was really and truly more for me than for her.
Yeah, I mean, I think especially with women, I think women has the need to let it out, you know, and...
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah.
It don't help for us to insert ourselves in there and just, you know. And I think the biggest part is sometimes, man, we try to put in the last word in there. We have to contribute. we're the biggest contributor of fights sometimes. That's not good, you know.
Oh, trust me, you hit it right on the head, John. I know that there could have been 100 things that I could have said, you know, when I had that call on Sunday, but I just chose to shut up and listen, because if I were to meddle in his plan, I would have just ruined it. I would have started getting angry or upset or saying things, you know, of the flesh, and that doesn't help. So, you know, I said, okay, I appreciate it, and we can talk later over this. And she's like, I need time. I'm like, you got it. And I'm going to continue to move forward my way and in my walk, because that's what I need to do to heal myself. And if it's all meant to be, it's all meant to be. But at least that little something was there. So that was more than what you had heard about and stuff, you know, when we talked before. So that's what I wanted to share with you, John.
Well, that's JBG on that one. Jesus.
No, for sure, buddy. For sure. But yeah. So you know, keeping hope alive, and you know, he needs to do his work, and I don't need to meddle in it, because I'm not perfect. He is. So you know, he's got this. He's got this.
Yeah.
Yeah. So where are you at right now?
I'm in Ontario, California.
Ontario. Okay. Oh, okay. That's where my niece lives out there. She's real, real close to you. So, yeah.
I've decided to I've decided to go through Phoenix, Arizona this time. Just different scenery, I guess.
Yeah.
It's only an hour longer, but I figured, you know, going through Salt Lake is also a couple hours longer. So, and we're allowed to go through Wyoming and all that stuff. They don't mind.
Now, when they actually provide you the routes and everything, they, just from what I heard, right, they do try to provide you the most gas-saving routes, but can you try to deviate, you know, according to the weather and all that stuff?
They actually don't give us the route.
They don't?
No,
okay.
No, we're free to choose which route we will go, but, you know, to run the shortest and most efficient route. And there is a certain percentage that, you know, out of route miles, and of course you can't abuse it. I mean, you certainly can't run from here all the way to Houston, Texas, and then go up, you know. I mean, that's just abuse. I mean, that's...
Well, yeah. And then I'm sure you'd be missing out on the fuel bonus, too, you know, because you're going to run more. So, I get it.
And not to mention that, you know, you're using up your hours. So
Hey, so I was thinking, Johnny, what if you were to try to head back but go through the way that Barbara was saying the other day, to go through her way, you know, through her neck of the woods? What do you think?
I don't know. I think that's something I need to explore, but right now my plan is to go through Phoenix, Flagstaff, and then through Kansas City, or I might even run 44 all the way to... I think that's a little too far, because I'm headed towards Dubuque, Iowa, so I don't think that would work. But I'll definitely ask her.
So
are you...
So I actually heard her interview probably like an hour and a half ago. Really happy that I had the chance to hear her voice. I mean, she has a certain way of writing her comments and her expressions and everything, and her voice matched the expressions in the commentary sections. It was really cool to hear, and her story is very, very... how can I say this? You know, no offense to Barbara, of course, at all, but her story is very tragic, but very very warming and uplifting. So I thought it was very cool. Very good interview on that one.
Well, she had me at hello.
I'm sure she did. Yeah. She seems like a real cool lady.
She had her laugh, you know, her laugh alone was worth the...
I know, right? Yeah.
She's got a really nice warm laugh, so...
Yeah.
So are you working today or what?
Yep. I am working today. I plan to leave in probably the next 3 hours or so to go get Janessa from school, and then we're going to hang out the weekend. I have to get the last bit of Christmas shopping for her brothers and sisters, so that'll be what we're going to do.
Let's see. If anybody that you know there wants to be heard on air, just let them know. Give them my number.
I will. There's a couple folks, like I said, who have just recently been introduced here to the channel and everything, and I think one of them is right now, she's trying to watch the Barbara Miller interview, you know, because I said, hey, you need to check this one out. So I will let you know.
All right. Well, thanks for calling and talking to me, Carlos. And I, once again, I apologize I could not get back to you last night.
Oh, don't worry about it, man. Trust me, we know what you're doing. And, yeah, no worries. So have a good day, and great day to everybody else that's listening. And, yeah, happy holidays, guys.
All right. Well, take care, Carlos.
All right, man. You too, John. See ya.
Bye.
Bye.
Well, that was some positive news. For those of you who don't know, Carlos has been having marital problems, and they are currently separated right now. But seems like there's a little bit of a crack in there, a little hope. Okay. So we'll keep them in our prayers and our positive thoughts. But I guess we are definitely going to Phoenix. We are definitely going to Phoenix. Oh, by the way, one of you out there, or any of you out there, have Facebook Messenger. Maybe you guys can call me on the Facebook Messenger also. That's one avenue, one way to call me. And I don't know, I have not yet tried Facebook Messenger yet. Facebook Messenger call, that is. So it'd be interesting to see if you guys could try Facebook Messenger, and what else, it might work. Let's give it a try right now. Hey, Scott. Hello. Scott? I don't know, it's not working, Scott. I was just trying to see if it works. I don't know if you could hear me or not.
Can you hear
me? Yeah, I don't know why. Hold on, okay, hold on. No, this is not working. Yeah, Scott, it's not working. Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hey, there you are.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm trying to, you're my guinea pig. I've never tried calling on Facebook Messenger before.
Oh, Facebook Messenger, huh?
Yeah. By the way, you're on YouTube, if that's something you don't mind, or what?
No, I do not mind that at all.
Okay, well,
I think that's awesome.
So, Scott, welcome to the JBG channel, and I don't think we've ever communicated before, right?
We have not.
No? Where are you from, Scott?
New York.
You're from New York?
I'm actually living in Jackson, Michigan.
Jackson, Michigan. Where is that about?
About an hour from Detroit.